Yeah, man.
Welcome back, Sports Chat 503 out of Southeast Portland, Oregon. We're talking today about Ernie Kent, head coach of the Ducks basketball team. They're building a new stadium for the Duckies to play in next year. I think they just had the last game.
Last Pac-10 season game.
Yeah.
Going to play the preseason next year, and then
Pac-10
opener is the opener of the new gym.
Oh, okay. But could be Ernie Kent's last game.
Was.
Last night, was it?
Was.
As Ducks head coach. So the questions we have are, what do you think about that? Possibilities? Yeah, where do the Ducks go?
First of all, Ernie Kent, I am a humongous fan.
Hats off?
Hats off.
Hats off to you, Ernie Kent.
Grew up as a family of Ducks. My whole family was there. My family was there right as Ernie was just getting there. Ernie's 73 to 77, I believe. And part of the greatest basketball team we've ever had at University of Oregon, which is the Kamikaze Kids. He was on the tail end of the Kamikazes, but he's still a part of it.
Yeah.
And he just lived and died at University of Oregon basketball, and he lived and died Matt Court, and you know what? It seems kind of odd, but he got buried with that gym. They closed that gym, and they closed Ernie at the same time. Yeah. If Ernie would have won this year, he would have gone in the other gym, but any year that Ernie would have failed to win, he's done. He was on his last legs, and I never was in support of it. I always was in support of keeping Ernie. Ernie's also a guy, though, who was going to coach at University of Oregon until he was done. He would be 80 years old coaching at U of O. So you're going to have to clip him at some point.
Yeah.
I mean, and the way they did it this time, they gave him an opportunity to go and look at other jobs. They gave him an opportunity to do it at the right time during the season. But, he might still coach. If they get into some sort of these tournaments that you can buy into, CBI, the Oregon State bought into it last year and actually won it.
Yeah.
There's other sort of little tournaments.
No idea what you're talking about.
Yeah. Nobody else knows either.
Really? Yeah. But
literally,
I have no idea.
It's a tournament at the end of the year that you buy into. It's like, I think $30,000 or $40,000. You buy into it. You host games at your place. You have it at the other teams. And about three teams get into it. And it's a tournament to just have postseason play. It is like
that sounds pretty good.
It's like the B team held a tournament too.
Yeah,
it's
that
like
sounds good, man.
The JVs.
Yeah, if I was a senior, I'd want to go into that.
Anybody,
tournament
any
to play,
any
you know?
Team that can play postseason is good.
Yeah,
it's just more practice. It's just more exposure.
Yeah, that's cool, man.
Yeah, but I would love to see Ernie go out and in his own way, and he didn't, and that's too bad because this is a young team, and this team is gonna win. This team might win next year. It might win the year after. And the guy who wins with that team is going to get the credit for it. And it's actually Ernie's team.
Yeah.
And if Ernie would have been able to coach it, he would have been able to win.
Yeah.
But Ernie is not the greatest game coach. They come out of timeouts weak. They come out of timeouts and turn the ball over.
Yeah, that's
you can't
difficult.
Call a timeout and turn the ball over. They also come out of timeouts sometimes and drop the shot clock. 35 seconds. And they can't get a shot up. After a timeout?
Yeah.
So there are some issues there. He's also been known to be a bit of a screamer, as most college coaches are.
Yeah.
If you listen to any interview, there's no voice box left.
Yeah, no kidding.
What left is completely damaged.
Yeah.
But he's coaching during the game. I'm a huge fan of John Wooden, and John Wooden rolled up that newspaper and just sat there and watched that team play because he coached during the week.
Yeah.
And Ernie was constantly yelling for the guy to be over here, and that annoyed me because I listened to the games on the radio. Terribly annoying.
Yeah.
But Ernie's a great one. He still loves the university. There's no animosity from his point of view. He said it. I watched the interview with him, and I believe him. He owes everything to that university.
Yeah.
That university gave him his education, gave him his start in basketball, gave him his start gave him a start in big time coaching.
Yeah.
And he's going to be able to get a big time job. He could go down south and get a big-time job. He could go up to – he recruited very well in the Midwest. He's from Chicago originally. So he could go back to the Midwest and work. He's got these guys out of Detroit. He's got numerous guys out of there. He could possibly get a gig there. But I wish the best for Ernie. He's had his kids come through Oregon, there's just – I'm glad he got to be able to have his kids go through Oregon and have that all be done.
Yeah, that's
kind
of nice.
And not be in this kind of thing. But he's the greatest coach Oregon has ever had. You cannot
Yeah.
There's no better. Hobby Hobson won the tournament in 1939 when I think 8 teams played in it.
Yeah.
There was one Oregon fan, and it was the guy's mom. She's an 80-year-old woman.
He still lives with her
today. But, dude, I mean, I'm serious. Ernie's the best coach ever. So, clipping him, you had to do it at some point. I understand that. A lot of Duck fans, even people in my own family, thought that he should have been gone a couple years ago. And I just... I would be sad when Ernie left at any time. It could be 20 years from now, I'd still be sad about it because I really love Ernie, and I really love that Matt Court. But I do believe that this new arena is going to be beautiful and awesome, and it's going to take Oregon basketball to a different level.
Yeah.
And that new coach might have to be somebody else. So.
Yeah, I think that Ernie Kent could have gone a little while back, a few years ago. But, I mean, I don't think between now and then we would have had a coach that would have been able to step in and do a whole lot better. Didn't do great this year, which is kind of a problem.
2 years in a row. Last year was horrible.
Yeah.
This year was better. This year was the Ducks. They were the most winning worst team ever.
It's kind of like the best of the worst. Nice.
They had the most wins inside a Pac-10 schedule for being the worst team in the Pac-10.
That's pretty good, actually.
So either that means the Pac-10 was really bad,
so
there was enough wins in there to just keep getting wins, which it was, or that means that the Ducks were really good as being a bad team.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's, probably call them A, but...
Yeah, it's tough because, like I was saying... I don't know of any names that are going to step in and be able to fill his shoes, not just, with
a few.
Yeah, because, I mean, we're used to somebody like Ernie Kent, because he's kind of left a little bit of a legacy, a little stamp on the program.
13 or 14 years, I think.
Yeah, and we're going to want somebody that's going to be able to do the same, and I think if you think Duck fans are... kind of scared or upset now, wait until you get somebody who's not putting it together after a couple years, and then you fire them and get somebody else, and then you got a coach for a couple years, he doesn't work out, you fire him, you get somebody else. There's something to say about having some longevity or having some staying power.
Well, Mark Few, supposedly the report was that he wanted 10 years, $25 million, guaranteed. And the Ducks said no to that. That was a year or so ago. That was maybe, I don't know how long ago that was.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm thinking 2 or 3 years. Well, Mark Few has his niche at Gonzaga. And I'm real. I don't know if Mark Few is able to do what Mark Few does at Gonzaga at Oregon.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I know Oregon has opportunities. I know Oregon has resources. But I don't know if he could do the same thing he does there. Because of the conference, because of where they're at, I don't know. You still, in the Pac-10, have to compete with Arizona, UCLA, SC, UCLA, I've already mentioned that, Cal, Washington.
Yeah.
All these schools are prominent. And Oregon State's getting better. And the idea, and I mean, Washington State went on a tear and was in the tournament for about 3 or 4 or 5 years.
Arizona State,
same thing. So it's a difficult conference to succeed in. And I think that the Pac-10, by being that, or real true Oregon fans, don't necessarily see the Duck basketball as being one of those preeminent programs that's in the top 10.
Yeah.
Or, not top 10, in the top 3 or 4. I think we're constantly around 5 or 6.
They'd have to be in the top 10, right?
I think this year we were hoping they were in the top 10. But I think, you know, by being 8 or 9 or 10, that's not comfortable. I think being in the 5, 6 is really comfortable for most Duck fans.
Yeah.
We're comfortable with that. Going and seeing a game where we might be able to get a victory. Yeah. That's what we're trying to look for. But I didn't see that this year. We saw a victory there this year.
Yeah, Montana State.
Yeah.
It was good, man.
I went to the Cal game and saw a blowout. So
it's
just one of those things. All right.
Yeah, it's great to see Matt Court. Gonna miss Matt Court.
Yeah, Matt Court's a great one.
Yeah.
It's an old barn and the new one's gonna be beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay, Doug fans. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Tune in, Sports Chat 503.
Check out the other videos, especially the football stuff. We're all over it.
And be good.
Adios.